Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. I'm Yasub and most of you remember me from the Python Tips blog, and today I will teach you the basics of web scraping using Python. First of all, why should you even bother learning how to web scrape? If your job doesn't require you to learn it, then let me give you some motivation. What if you want to create a website which curates cheapest products from Amazon, Walmart, and a couple of other online stores? A lot of these online stores don't provide you with an easy way to access their information using an API. Even if they have an API, it is usually rate limited, so you don't have a lot of flexibility there. In the absence of an API, your only choice is to create a web scraper, which can extract information from these websites automatically and provide you with that information in an easy to use way. Here is an example of a typical API response in JSON. This is the response from Reddit. There are a lot of Python libraries out there which can help you with web scraping. There is lxml, Beautiful Soup, and a full-fledged framework called Scrapy. Most of the tutorials discuss Beautiful Soup and Scrapy, so I decided to go with lxml in this screencast. I will teach you the basics of XPaths and how you can use them to extract data from an HTML document. I will take you through a couple of different examples so that you can quickly get up to speed with lxml and XPaths. If you are a gamer, you will already know of and likely love this website. We will be trying to extract data from Steam. More specifically, we will be extracting data from the popular new releases section. I might convert this into a two-part series. For now, we will be creating a Python script which can extract the names of the games, the prices of the games, the different tags associated with each game, and the target platforms. Step 1. First of all, open up the popular new releases page on Steam and scroll down until you see the popular new releases tab. At this point, I usually open up Chrome Developer Tools and see which HTML tags contain the required data. I extensively use the Element Inspector tool, which is the button in the top left of the Developer Tools. It allows you to see the HTML markup behind a specific element on the page with just one click. As a high-level overview, everything on a web page is encapsulated in an HTML tag, and tags are usually nested. You need to figure out which tags you need to extract the data from, and you are good to go. In our case, if we take a look, we can see that every separate list item is encapsulated in an anchor tag. The anchor tags themselves are encapsulated in the div with an ID of tab_new_releases_content. I am mentioning the ID because there are two tabs on this page. The second tab is the standard new releases tab, which we don't want to extract the information from. Hence, we will first extract the popular new releases tab, and then we will extract the required information from this extracted tag. Step 2. Start writing a Python script. This is the perfect time to create a new Python file and start writing down our script. I am going to create a scrape.py file. Now let's go ahead and import the required libraries. The first one is the request library and the second one is the lxml.html library. The request library is going to help us open the web page in Python. We could have used lxml to open the HTML page, but it doesn't work well with all web pages. So to be on the safe side, I am going to use requests. Now let's open up the web page using requests and pass that response to lxml.html.fromstring method. This provides us with an object of HTML element type. This object has the XPath method which we can use to query the HTML document. This provides us with a structured way to extract information from an HTML document. Step 3. Fire up the Python interpreter. Now save this file and open up a terminal. Copy the code from the scrape.py file and paste it in a Python interpreter session. We are doing this so that we can quickly test our XPaths without continuously editing, saving, and executing our scrape.py file. Let's try writing an XPath for extracting the div which contains the popular new releases tab. I will explain the code as we go along. This statement will return a list of all the divs in the HTML page which have an ID of tab_new_releases_content. Now, because we know that only one div on the page has this ID, we can take out the first element from the list, and that would be our required div. Let's break down the XPath and try to understand it. These double forward slashes tell lxml that we want to search for all tags in the HTML document which match our requirements. Another option was to use a single forward slash. The single forward slash returns only the immediate child tags or nodes which match our requirements. Div tells lxml that we are searching for divs in the HTML page. And this particular piece of code tells lxml that we are only interested in those divs which have an ID of tab underscore new releases underscore content. Cool! We have got the required div. Now let's go back to Chrome and check which tags contain the titles of the new releases. Step 4. Extract the titles and prices. The title is contained in a div with a class of tab underscore item underscore name. Now that we have the popular new releases tab extracted, we can run further XPath queries on that tab. Write down the following code in the same Python console which we previously ran our code in. This gives us with the titles of all of the games in the popular new releases tab. Here is the expected output. Let's break down this XPath a little bit as well because it's a bit different from the last one. Here, our dot tells lxml that we are only interested in the tags which are the children of the new releases tag. This particular filter is pretty similar to how we were filtering divs based on ID. The only difference is that here we are filtering based on the class name. And forward slash text tells lxml that we want the text contained within the tag we just extracted. In this case, it returns the title contained in the div with the tab underscore item underscore name class name. Now we need to extract the prices for the games. We can easily do that by running the following code. I don't think I need to explain this code as it is pretty similar to the title extraction code. The only change we made is the change in the class name. Step 5. Extracting tags. Now we need to extract the tags associated with the titles. Here is the HTML markup. Write down the following code in the Python terminal to extract the tags. You can pause the video at any time to take a better look at the code. I will also provide code files with this video so that it is easier for you to check whether you wrote the correct code or not. So what are we doing here? We are extracting the divs containing the tags for the games. Then we loop over the list of extracted tags and then extract the text from those tags using the text underscore content method. Text underscore content method returns the text contained within an HTML tag without the HTML markup. We could have also made use of a list comprehension to make that code shorter. I wrote it down in this way so that even those who don't know about list comprehensions can understand the code. Either ways, let's go ahead and convert this code into a list comprehension because you already know how to do it normally. Let's separate the tags in a list as well so that each tag is a separate element. Step 6. Extracting the platforms. Now the only remaining thing is to extract the platforms associated with each title. Here is the HTML markup. The major difference here is that the platforms are not contained as text within a specified tag. They are listed as the class name. Some titles only have one platform associated with them, like this, while some other titles have 5 platforms associated with them, like this. As we can see, these spans contain the platform type as a class name. The only common thing between these spans is that all of them contain the platform underscore image class. First of all, we will extract the divs with the tab underscore item underscore details class. Then we will extract the spans containing the platform underscore image class. And finally, we will extract the second class name from those spans. Write down this following code. In line 1, we start with extracting the tab underscore item underscore details div. The XPath in line 5 is a bit different. Here we have this, instead of simply having add class equals platform underscore image. The reason is that add class equals platform underscore image returns those spans which only have the platform underscore image class associated with them. If these spans have an additional class, they won't be returned. Whereas this filters all the spans which have the platform underscore image class. It doesn't matter whether it is the only class or if there are more classes associated with that tag. In line 6, we are making use of a list comprehension to reduce code size. The .get method allows us to extract an attribute of a tag. Here, we are using it to extract the class attribute of a span. We get a string back from the .get method. In case of the first game, the string being returned is platform underscore image win. Win is in Windows. So we split that string based on the comma and the white space. And then we store the last part, which is the actual platform name, of the split string in the list. In lines 7 to 8, we are removing the HMD separator from the list if it exists. This is because HMD separator is not a platform. It is just a vertical separator bar used to separate actual platforms from VR AR hardware. Step 7, conclusion. This is the code we have so far. Now we just need this to return a JSON response so that we can easily turn this into a Flask Space API. Here is the code. This code is self-explanatory. We are using the zip function to loop over all of those lists in parallel. Then we create a dictionary for each game and assign the title, price, tags, and platforms as separate key in that dictionary. Lastly, we append that dictionary to the output list. In a future screencast, we might take a look at how to convert this into a Flask-based API and host it on Heroku. But this is going to be the final step in this particular screencast. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. If you want to read more tutorials of a similar nature, please go to Python Tips. I regularly write Python tips, tricks, and tutorials on that blog. And if you are interested in learning intermediate Python, then please check out my open source book here. If you have any feedback based on this screencast, please share it in the comments below. I would love to improve future screencasts, and your feedback is the only way for me to know what to improve. Have a great day!